My name is Clint. I have a short, simple, educational video for all you Mosin-Nagant enthusiasts out there on the bolt assembly for the M9130 Mosin-Nagant. I have here a 1942 Ischefs model, as well as a 1933 Tula. We're gonna focus primarily on the 1942 Ischefs bolt. So first step to disassembling the bolt. It's very simple. You can field strip it if you'd like. It's just press and hold down the trigger. So the bolt slides right out. Lay down your rifle and begin. It is imperative that when you first purchase your Mosin-Nagant that you disassemble the bolt so that you can clean all of the cosmoline out. At first it may seem like a daunting task to do so, but I'm gonna do it really slowly so you can watch really closely and just keep rewinding until you get it. Don't get frustrated when doing this, just take it slow and watch closely. Hold it in your left hand like you're holding a pistol on the charging knob. Make sure the cocking knob is in the rear and the bolt head is in the front. Turn it over, your back hand facing up, holding on to the charging knob. Take your right hand, pull back with your palm facing up in your right hand. Slightly compress the spring in the bolt, rotate it counterclockwise. In my view, it's counterclockwise. Once rotated, you're looking at it. It should be, this is the safety mechanism. It should be on the left side when looking at it from the rear. My view, now your view. And the charging knob should be in the top. When it's in this position, the two pieces, the bolt head, as well as the bolt, the firing pin guide, should come apart. And we come to the next phase of disassembly. There are two methods that can be used to remove the firing pin and spring. First method is, you take a teardrop shaped tool, you take the last notch closest to the hole in the tool, you stick it, you slide it in to the flat part, like so, of the firing pin, and you rotate it. And you can just unscrew it all the way, and you'll slowly see the firing pin depress in the cocking knob all the way until it's undone. I'm gonna show you the other way. I'm gonna put it back. Press the firing pin into a soft piece of wood. Don't do it on concrete or steel. You don't wanna damage your firing pin. All you do is you press down real hard, compress the spring all the way, and then just unscrew the cocking knob. Just turn it counterclockwise, left, lefty-loosey, until it comes off, and slowly release. And out comes your firing pin and the spring. So now we have the bolt completely disassembled, all six individual parts. So now we're gonna reassemble it real quick. First thing you wanna do is grab the spring, place it on the back of the firing pin, slide that in the main body of the firing pin in the big hole as compared to the small hole. Press that down into a soft piece of wood until the spring is all the way compressed. Take your cocking knob, the rear mechanism, put that on top, start screwing it clockwise to your right to tighten it, the reverse of what you did to unscrew it. Do that all the way until you come back down and the rear becomes flush, roughly flush. It doesn't have to be perfect to where the cocking knob, make sure it's all close enough. Then you want to take your tool, this lip right here, like I said, to unscrew on the firing pin, put that on the lip, turn that until it's lined up with the notches engraved. Once you have the firing pin and spring re-screwed onto the cocking knob and main body charging knob, you take the guide rail, roll them like this. Firing pin should have horizontal parallel flat, as well as round on the side, same as this hole on the guide rail. Slide that in, slide it all the way down. See this notch right here on the rear of the cocking knob? You should slide it right in perfectly on these rails. Now this is the trickiest part of reassembling the bolt, so watch closely. If you look close, you see this valley right here. Take it and you make sure that it's this notch right here next to the firing pin slides right in.
So you line it up, slides right in. Once that notch is lined up, what you do is you pull it halfway out, don't completely, make sure it stays in that notch, and then you rotate it. Before you rotate it, you locate this notch right here, and it goes right into the hole on the top. That's lined up perfectly with the charging knob. Pull it halfway out, and then slide that in. Now it's all good to go. Now before you lock up and rotate your cocking knob and put your reassembled bolt back into your Mosin, you want to check the headspace on the firing pin. The way that you do that is take your tool and second one from the right is 1.92 millimeters. It's called the no-go. Third one from the right is the 2.42 millimeter head gauge, and it is the go. So what you do is you take the first notch and you rest that on the lip so that you can fit your other gauges down. The first one from the right is called the no-go, so it shouldn't go on your head. If it goes, then your firing pin is way too low and it might not strike the primer. So once you readjust that and it's no-go, then you go to the third one from the right, and this is your go, and it better go. If it doesn't go, then your headspace is too high, and your firing pin might over-aggressively strike the primer, which will result in the bolt possibly flying back into your eye socket and removing your good eye that you use to aim down your sights, which would not be a good thing. So we're all good on the headspace, so we're a go to lock it up and put it back in the Mosin. So make sure you support the bolt head so it doesn't come apart on you. Take your thumb, wrap it over the charging knob, pull back slightly on the cocking knob, rotate it clockwise, make sure that this notch is stayed in the guardrail, and it locks. It's all locked, and it shouldn't come apart. And before, just to make sure, just do a double check, make sure that this notch is in this railing, this top one is in that notch.
Take your reassembled and locked in bolt, hold it like you're holding a pistol upside down. Once again, pull on the trigger on your Mosin, slide it right in. Hold down the trigger all the way until you cock it to the side, lock it, and release the trigger. That way it's not engaged. Make sure you're pointing it in the right direction, and you're good to go. That'll do it for this edition of my Mosin workshop. Stay tuned for more information, old videos that I'm putting out. Be a troll fuckhead in the comments if you like, but keep in mind, a wise man once said, eat shit and die, and that's that.
On a Monday, I was arrested, On a Tuesday, they locked me in the jail.
Oh, boy.
On a Wednesday, my trial was attested. On a Thursday, they said guilty, and the judge's gavel fell. I got stripes around my shoulders. I got chained around my feet. I got stripes around my shoulders. And them chains, they're about to drag me down. On a Monday, my mama come to see me. On a Tuesday, they caught me with a file. On a Wednesday, I'm down in solitary. On a Thursday, I start on bread and water for a while. I got stripes around my shoulders. I got chains around my feet. I got stripes around my shoulders. And them chains, they're about to drag me down. I got stripes around my shoulders. I got chains around my feet. I got stripes around my shoulders. And them chains, they're about to drag me down.